Now what we have on this tree is called a swarm of honeybees. And honeybees swarm when they're expanding their hive and when there's been a new queen. What they do is they fly out of the hive and they collect on the branch of a tree, for example, like this. And while they're on this tree with the queen, their scouts go out and look for a new habitat for the hive. So this colony has the old queen with it. It's been superseded, and there's a new queen inside the old hive body. When several scouts come back with the exact same location information for a new suitable cavity for them to live in, then this whole swarm will then again head out and occupy that new cavity. This particular swarm is really close to the ground right now, so it's easy for me to get to them and to share it with you. Once they find a suitable cavity, they'll all fly out again in mass. Now what I'm going to do is move the camera in really close so you can see that some of the worker bees that are with this swarm are carrying pollen resources with them to help start their new hive. And somewhere in the middle of this mass of bees is the queen. Now in general, it's the old queen that is driven out and leaves the hive, and it's the new queen that occupies the existing hive while the old queen sets out with this group of workers. When you see this edge of the hive, or the colony actually, I should say, they're all just hanging off of the bodies of the other bees that are clinging to the structure of the tree. What I'm doing now is just sitting around watching this colony of bees that have swarmed and I'm waiting for them to find their new location and then swarm away again, and hopefully I can get footage of that for you. You can see how close I am to them. They're right here on this branch. And as I said before, when they're in a swarm mode, they're not defensive, so it's really not something you should panic about if a cloud of bees flies overhead as these did and they accumulated on this tree. So they're just looking for a new home. And once they have the new home, then that's an area that they'll set up house in and possibly have to defend later. But it's really interesting to see them in a swarm. Problem is now it's late August and their chances for survival are really not too good. Now what you're seeing is the same branch that that whole swarm had been clinging to before. I went and got protective clothing on, and I came back, and finding the swarm still here, I took pruning shears and cut away all the extra branches. Then I cut off the branch that had the swarm clinging to it, and I moved them all into an empty hive body. So now the swarm has a hive of drawn comb in which to live. What you're seeing here clinging to what's left of the branch are the scouts returning that can't now find their hive. But the swarm will be putting off a pheromone that these scouts will again locate, and then they'll re-inhabit the box that I put the swarm in. I took a regular beehive frame, pulled out all the frames and used the box empty, put the branch inside. And that's now what houses the bees. I'm sorry I wasn't able to show you the process because I'm filming this alone and couldn't film myself cutting away the branch and then hand carrying the swarm to the hive body. Now what I want you to notice too is these scouts that have come back are doing a little waggle dance. And this waggle is telling the others the location of a suitable place to live. Really kind of cool to see that. The waggle dance gives a position of the site that they've found relevant to the sun. And they're each competing, trying to tell the others that their location is the best one to go to. Now I'll show you the box that I put the bees in. Now what we're looking at here is the wide open entryway to the hive bodies that I put the swarm in. These bottom two frames, or hive bodies, are actually full of drawn comb and it has nutrients in it ready to go. These top two frames, or hive bodies again, I'm sorry. These top two hive bodies are actually empty. And that's where I put the branch with the swarm still clinging to it. Eventually, they'll discover the drawn comb and that the rest of the hive is unoccupied, and hopefully they'll set up house here. Some of the scouts are already starting to locate this area, and they're going in and out of that opening. I'll know better by tomorrow morning if they actually remained in this hive body. And I hope they do.